Now we will discuss the practical applications of nanotechnology. So these are the practical applications of nanotechnology which are available in the market: high performance skyvacs, breathable waterproof sky jacket, wrinkle resistant or stain repellent threads, deep penetrating skin creams, OLED digital camera, nanotech DVD and book collections, performance sunglasses, nano crystalline sunscreen, high tech tennis rackets and balls, and few of them we will discuss here. First one is nano sunblock. When we are discussing the nano sunblock, so whatever the nano sunscreen available in the market, some of them are using chemicals to block the sun rays, but some of the sunscreen they use nano particles such as zinc oxide and others. And how it works? Now, if rays fall on the skin, so it absorbs the light. So when we apply a coating of sunscreen or sunblock, so either they absorb the rays or they reflect the rays. So which helps to protect the sun rays to reach the skin. And they protect the transmission of sun rays. The clocks are always better because they absorb more of the UV rays than sunscreens. So this is the application of sunblock. Here we will discuss the nano silver products. These are some of the products based on the nanotechnology in which we have used silver nanoparticles. I will discuss the socks. Now we know when some person wear the socks and after few hours there is a foul smell in their socks. So to stop that smell because of microbial growth. So hence silver nanoparticles has been added with the fiber. As we know, silver nanoparticles having antimicrobial properties which inhibit the growth of the microbes, and in this way we stop the foul smell and we can wear the socks for a longer time. So this is a very important application, and even silver nanoparticles have been used in the water treatment also and many more places. After the silver products, now move to energy sector. We know lithium-ion batteries acquire the market a lot. First, when we are talking about the lithium-ion batteries, the first impression in our mind is our smartphone. In the smartphone, we are using lithium-ion batteries. In all the smartphones, we are using only lithium-ion batteries. And soon we have electrical cars with the lithium-ion batteries. Now, what is the benefit of lithium-ion battery and related to lithium-ion battery? Because the charging and discharging is a major issue in the conventional batteries. In the conventional batteries, the charging and discharging cycle is less. But when we are talking about the lithium-ion batteries, the charging and discharging cycles are very huge. And as per the scientific report, we can say approximately a lithium-ion battery that can run to 20,000 cycles. Means we can use at least 20 years a single battery. While conventional battery, we have to change after 3 or 4 years later. So this is the major advantage. Second advantage, charging is very fast. Third advantage, the lifetime and last longer time is more in case of lithium-ion battery. And how it will work? This is one of the cathode material, lithium cobalt, and there are so many cathode materials which are available in the market. This is the first one. And intercalation and deintercalation are taking place during charging and discharging of lithium ion battery. This is the one of the schematic diagram. Now we move to another part, high tech tennis rackets and balls. We know that when we are having the match with the tennis, so tennis rackets and balls always play very important role. It's not the strength of the player, it's also the strength of the your tennis racket. Means increasing the strength of tennis racket by adding nanotube to the frames, which increase the control and power on hitting the ball. It means racket also plays very important. And now nanocomposite has been utilized for the tennis ball also. This nano makes tennis ball bouncer for a longer time. Means we don't have to change the ball again and again. So it means nanotechnology also plays a role in the not only tennis rackets and ball. Now these days, almost many of the games we are using nanotechnology. Now in water treatment, this is the nanomaterial based water technology Amrit to remove arsenic. Here we have used iron hydroxide nanoparticles, iron oxyhydroxide nanoparticles for the removal of arsenic, developed by IIT Chennai, Professor T. Pradeep. Now, this is one of the techniques which based on the nanotechnology. And now these technology have been utilized throughout the India and various parts for the removal of arsenic, the heavy metal, which cause lot of health problems. Next is the flexible electronics. Now in future, it is likely that graphene will become a dominant material in flexible electronics. Stretchable electronics or flexible electronics is likely to be the future of mobile electronics also. And in some of the countries, we have flexible electronics already there. Now we will see when it will reach to India. Next, whenever we are talking about the nanotechnology, then transport sectors is equally important. We can't ignore the transport sector, because after a significant development in the field of transportation, it will put an imprint in the development of our society. Therefore, industries are now heavily investing in research and development in order to develop safety, environmental friendly, comfort, and outstanding transportation system. And for that, the nanomaterials have been utilized in almost all the parts of the automobile. Nanomaterials in fuel cell and battery that we have already discussed, self-cleaning nanofilms, which that we have already heard regarding the lotus leaf, heat shield, resin nanopolymer, nano additives, lubricants, nano coating, nanoparticles in tire for the long running cycles, catalyst nanomaterials, nano grained engines, nano sensors, and polymeric nanocomposite. Means almost I think all parts of body, the industry now using nanotechnology for the automobile industry, which gives us more and more comfort. Next part is nanomedicine. Means nanoparticles, these in future will move. Now in this slide, we will discuss the role of nanomaterials as a nanomedicine. And nanomedicine means nanomaterials, whether it is magnetic, whether it is optical nanomaterials, we are talking about the nanoparticles. So whenever we treating the nanoparticles as a nanomedicine, so it is used to treat almost all kind of disease, whether it is related to Parkinson's disease, to Alzheimer's, fungal, bacterial, kidney disease, diabetes, AIDS, cancer, tuberculosis, hepatitis, almost in all of the fields, the scientists now using nanoparticles to treat these type of disease. And in future, we will see that inorganic nanoparticles will replace the organic medicine. And these are the several selective nanomaterials and their applications. That semiconducting nanoparticles, that is quantum dots, they have fluorescence and multi-photon bioimaging. In vitro diagnosis, in vivo fluorescence imaging, drug delivery, photodynamic therapy. Rare earth-based nanoparticles, biomolecular labeling, or detection of an intracellular signaling processes, deep tissue bioimaging, sensitive biosensing. Silica-based nanoparticles, same photothermal control, drug delivery, and cancer treatment, and bioimaging. So these are some of the nanomaterials which are utilized for different biomedical applications. So we will discuss one, that is photodynamic therapy. What is photodynamic therapy? The chemical, the nanoparticles is injected into the body. The chemical concentrated at the tumor site. Then we irradiate these parts with the light. And whenever the light falls on the nanomaterial, it gets activated and destroys the tumorous cell, as shown here. Now, nanocells, as we know, the cancer cells, these are uncontrollable growth, and there is always space between the cancer cells. So nanoparticles move in, cover the cancer cell while leaving behind the healthy cell. It will not cover the healthy cell because there is no space between them. But whenever we irradiate with the infrared light or higher wavelength light, which is non-harm to other parts, so they, due to photodynamic therapy, they destroy the cancer cell. And this is the mechanism of this one. And this is the one image, live image, that has been already in process. So we know the tissue, the higher it is, the higher wavelength light easily penetrate to the tissues, while the other one is unable to penetrate the tissue. And due to, because of this, we utilize nanoparticles for the photodynamic therapy. And in future, we will see this therapy is very common, will be very common. Now, we have discussed about the importance of nanomaterials. And we have seen it almost utilizing in all sectors of science. Now comes to nanotoxicity. Nanotoxicity is the opposite phase of nanotechnology, where nanotechnology is very beneficial for the human race. Same, on the other side, it also causes several toxicities. The toxic things to environment or human health. With the increasing use and production of nanomaterials, occupational exposure is also growing. Other concern is related to environment and ecosystem disturbance. Some of these apprehensions have forced scientists to investigate and understand the potential adverse effect of engineered nanomaterials on health and environment, and also exposure the challenges to assess the toxicity of these materials. Whenever we are discussing the toxicity, the several reports on toxicity assessment of nanomaterials published in the last few decades. However, still it is a challenging task to investigate the interaction of nanomaterials with the biological system, because the biological system is very complex, because outside, when the nanomaterials is outside, so it is very easy to characterize those nanomaterials. But when it enters into the human system or any biological system, it's very tough to analyze or characterize the nanoparticles, and how it interacts with the biological system is again a big task. And we know, see, these are the few exposure pathway of nano particles. Absorption, oral uptake, inhalation, dermal exposure, ocular exposure, or intravenous injection. So these are the few things through which we can expose to the nanoparticles. When we expose the nanoparticles, so it has many disadvantages, and these are health hazards. So these are the possible toxicity due to nanoparticles. These are some of the nanomaterials, and these are toxicity affect the central nervous system, respiratory tract, liver toxicity, pulmonary inflammation, inhibition of DNA enzymes, then nephrotoxic potential, DNA damage, almost we have seen. So many of the nanomaterials have similar types of possible risk. So it's always suggested utilize nanoparticles sincerely. And how they are dangerous? Because whenever nanomaterials enter into the cell or human body, it causes ROS, reactive oxygen species. Means nanomaterials generate reactive oxygen species through phantom reactions or Haber-Weiss cycle reactions, which cause formation of hydroxyl radical in the presence of hydrogen oxide. And also hydroxyl radicals have tendency to form superoxide anion radicals. And we know radicals are highly energetic, reactive, and highly unstable species. And they try to always attack the next biomolecule and destroy the biomolecules, and which cause several diseases. And those diseases are very severe, such as these are some of the schematic flowchart, lipid peroxidation, means membrane damage, mitochondria, mDNA damage, oxidative disorder, protein edit, enzyme dysfunction, nucleus, DNA edit, gene mutation. It may also take place. Means cytotoxicity, also genotoxicity. So these are the disadvantage of nanotechnology. And these are the human, and environment is also very dangerous. So in short, these are the list of numerous applications of nanomaterials in nanomedicine, that fluorescence, multiphotonic photon bioimaging, photodynamic therapy, bioimaging, tissue engineering, gene therapy, regenerative medicine, MRI, food and agriculture, nano fertilizers, nano fungicide, nano pesticide. We don't need a large amount of pesticide. We can spray only a nano pesticide, which is sufficient to kill the pest. Energy and environment, wastewater treatment, adsorption and degradation of organic and inorganic pollutants, nanofilters, solar energy, energy storage, hydrogen generation, lithium-ion batteries, in defense and security, smart materials, fuel additives, modern weapons, nanocoatings, nanocomposites, night vision cameras, sensors and electronics, robotics, automobiles, just now we have discussed, in buildings, pigments for interior and exterior paint, film on glass window, which has the self-cleaning properties, physiological behavior under unaxial extensional flow, climate control. So these are the important properties of nanotechnology. Electronic devices, OLED, LED, nanotransistors, nano-based memory device, optomagnetic spintronics, electrochromic device, nanogenerators. In textile industry also, smart fibers, stain repellents, wrinkle fringes, nanocoatings, high absorbency, softness, and breathability, military applications. Sports, nanofibers, ball protein, CNT-based sports items. These are the numerous applications of nanomaterials. And this is the schematic diagram. And last, this is the overview of the fate of nanoparticles and their impact on the environment and human health during the use of nanomaterials. Means we are utilizing nanomaterials also, but in somehow it also contaminates or pollutes the environment and human health. So for this, we have to utilize nanomaterials or nanotechnology in a sincere way, in a wiser way, so that we get benefit, more benefited from the nanotechnology, and it will less harm the environment and human health. Thank you so much for the listening me. This is my beautiful campus, and just now it celebrated Golden Jubilee, and this is my Nano Center. Thank you so much for your time. And this is the end of the talk. And there are a lot of things in nanotechnology, but we can't explain in a shorter time.